So, this is your first slab for physics 1030. What you've done already is taken a meter stick, taped it to a wall, and dropped two different balls from the set heights in the lab, 30 centimeters, 60 centimeters, 90 centimeters, and measured the bounce height. Okay? If you don't have a meter stick, and instead you have a yardstick in centimeters, and you've measured that distance in inches, when you convert it, you have to keep in mind what you're converting to. Chances are, if you did this on the centimeter side, you could probably only measure the ball to the nearest centimeter. Possibly not the nearest millimeter, which means when you convert it, you've got to put it to the whole centimeter. I shouldn't see too many decimal places after this. For people that put two decimal places down here, the comment back will be, so you must be able to see to the microscopic level. Because you cannot see with the naked eye below that point to the tenth of a millimeter. Okay? So I've got my data. Here's the data I'm going to use. 30 centimeters bounced back to 21, 60 bounced back to 46. Sorry, I partially erased that. 46, 90 to 70, and then I've got my 0 centimeter mark. There's a question on the lab about this. What is this? Why is this significant? What does this represent in real life is really what I'm trying to ask you. Because this graph represents real life. What happened at this point? That's the question. But now you have to make the graph. If you want to do this in Excel, you can do it in Excel. I give you instructions. Those instructions should get you most of the way if you have a newer version of Excel. Should still be very valid for 2013, but if you have the new 2016 Office package, maybe a slightly different, but the key is there's a graph you want to make no matter what version of Excel you make. And that is, you want to make an XY scatter plot. If you make a line graph, what it's going to do is take your two data points and connect the lines, and you're going to end up with something like this. That is not valid. That is not what we're trying to do here. Because what this tells me is the slope changes between each measurement. And that means how bouncy the ball is physically changed between those data points. And that's not true. So again, don't make the line graph. You will lose points for that. You make the XY scatter plot. And this is what we're going to do right now. So to make a graph with the data, first point's the easiest. I graph 0, 0. It's the origin. Then I'm going to go to 30 centimeters and 21 centimeters. So I've set this up. I'll make a couple points real quick. Title for the graph at the top. Axes labeled appropriately with the units that I'm graphing. In this case, I'm going to graph centimeters, but pay attention to your data because sometimes you want to graph meters. Okay. If you turn in a graph like I've drawn by hand on blank paper and the lines aren't straight, I'm not going to accept it. I'll tell you to redo it in graph paper. Do this on graph paper. That way everything's straight and it's easier to find the points. But I don't have graph whiteboard. So, I make my own. 30 centimeters, 21. All right, 30 centimeter drop height. This is the X variable. 21 centimeters for the bounce height. That's the Y. Then I have 60 and 46. About there. And then I'm going to have 90 and 70. Right about there. Now these look to be on a line, but they really aren't. If you try to line them up, all four of them up, they aren't quite all in the center. They're very close though, and that's probably due to the inaccuracy of my graph, is making it look even better than it is, and would be on graph paper. But let's say, let's exaggerate this a little bit. So now, I can't even touch all three. And in most cases, you won't be able to. So what we're going to do is draw what's called the best fit curve. The best fit curve, or the best fit line in this instance, is one that comes as close as possible to all three. And as a matter of fact, what I'm going to do, just to, again, exaggerate, I'm going to drop this one. Because what I'm trying to do then is get the line that is as far above the last point as it is below the middle point, and as close to the third point as possible. Okay, you're trying to get it as close to possible as all three. And there's my line. This is if you're drawing it by hand. If you're doing it in Excel, you first create the XY scatter plot, get the data points. Second step is you right-click on one of the data points, and you say to add a trend line. Make sure it's a linear line, which means a straight line, and it'll add it for you. Put the slope on it. It'll say something like y equals 0.72x. It may take it out to more decimal places, and that's fine. But this now is the equation of the line. We're not going to do anything with this value yet. That comes in lab number two. After this, what we actually need to do is graph the second ball's data on this graph. I'll have a second line. And that's the graph you need to take a picture of, scan in, and attach in the Dropbox. You can do that as a separate file from the Word document, or you can figure out how to paste it into the Word document. But if you do take a picture with your phone, make sure it's a high quality image, or else it's very hard for me to grade, to see and grade it. So that's how you do the graph portion of this lab. You have some questions to answer, and good luck on lab number one.